The 3D Chromosome Browser actually is one of the free tools on GEDmatch, so you can try it out with your free account. It is powerful because it actually does some of the functions that you would have to use the multiple kit analysis or some of the paid tools for in order to get similar results. The other thing about the 3D Chromosome Browser is that it is unique to GEDmatch. Now you may be saying, well, I've seen how 23andMe and Family Tree DNA and MyHeritage, you actually can use those browsers to look at multiple people at the same time, but that is not the same as the 3D Chromosome Browser. In a nutshell, with a regular chromosome browser, you are able to compare yourself to 1 to 5 or 6 or 7 or even more other people at the same time. So it's a 1 to 3 or 5 or 10 comparison. With a 3D chromosome browser, you're actually comparing everybody that you put in there to everybody else. So if you have 3 people, you're comparing 3 people all to those other 3 people. Now this may sound a little bit like triangulation, and it is, and that's why I say this tool can get you some of the results that others tools can get you that are on the paid side. So in the 3D Chromosome Browser initial part, it is going to ask you to enter between 3 and 10 kit numbers. My guess is they limit it at 10 kit numbers simply because the amount of data that you're being shown would simply be overwhelming and it would be hard to make heads or tails of it. I'm only going to use 3 kits today, and these 3 kits are all related to each other. I think third cousins are closer between all of them. And I've got the first page of the results. Now, I'll mention that again, that there's actually 2 pages. We're going to go to the second page in a second. But what I wanted to show you is this first page, because this is actually the part of the 3D Chromosome Browser that I use the most. What this is this is going to go through and list all of the segments that people in this group of 3 have in common. So first table here is what segments they have in common. So we can see this first person, BL, has 11 segments in common with JY. And then BL has 1 segment in common with Drew D. JY has 3 segments in common with Drew D. So you can start to see right off the bat, I'm not comparing one person to the other 2. I'm comparing all 3. If you have used the matrix tool in the multiple kit analysis, this next one will be very similar. This is the total amount of shared centimorgan. And again, you can see it's comparing between all of them, so I know how much each combination shares. Now I've done just 3 here, but you can do up to 10 on this tool. Next then is the X chromosome. It's seeing how much they share. Now I happen to know that these are all related through their paternal sides, and so I would not be expecting any X sharing because they're all males as well. Now we get to the chromosome summary. And this is going chromosome by chromosome, tells us how many segments for each individual, and then also the largest segments and where they are from. And then we get to the details. This is really the same thing as this table right here, only it is expanded out into each individual segment. So if we just start chromosome number 2, we see that there's 4 matching segments in this set. When we go down to this table, I can count 1, 2, 3, 4. There's my 4 matching segments on chromosome number 2. And then I can also see where that is. Now this range is going to be the lowest of those segments to the highest of those segments. So if I go down here and look at these 4 segments, I can see that the lowest is this 183, 56, 2648, and the highest is 216, 864, 687. The major difference then between these 2 tables is by dividing this out, I can see who is matching who in which location. And that goes for the whole genome. All of the different segments that are matching between them is divided out. You'll notice in some cases, we have all 3 people represented on a chromosome. In another case, we only have 2. And this is where one of the quirks are. Because of the way that this matches everything, you can see that there's always going to be at least 2. There's never going to be only 1. And that's because it matches JY to BL, And then it also matches BL to JY. So it's the same segment. It's just matched in different way between which person you have first, which person you have second, in order to get through all of the different people. And so that's why when you think about this, if we had 10 people here as opposed to 3, we could easily have 10 or 20 or 30 different matching segments on one chromosome and all throughout the genome there. But this is a nice quick way to be able to see which segments are matching, give you an idea of whether or not they are triangulated, because if you happen to find where they all match each other over the same segment, that's going to be triangulation. So there's a bit of triangulation found in here. You have to look for it. There is also just the segment search that is found in here. That's another tool on the tier one side. That is in here, as well as the multiple kit analysis, looking at some of the matrices analysis from this. So in this one tool, the 3D chromosome browser, so far, we have bits of multiple different tools that are represented. So let's get then to the next part. And this is really where it goes between what your preference is on how you like to look at the data. I happen to like to look at data in a table format because I can see how some of these numbers fit together and these segments overlap others. Other people actually like to have a more visual format. And that is where we get this graphic here. Now, this is showing the same data that we just saw on the table. The only difference is it's showing it in a more graphical format. So right here, this represents the three people that we're looking at. You can see that they are listed three across the top and three down the side. And it forms a little grid here. And this is where those segments lie. And it's starting off on chromosome number one. And remember, from that table, we didn't have any matching segments on chromosome number one. Our matches were on chromosome number two. When you click on this, it's going to put a drop-down menu, and it's going to show all of the different chromosomes. I know it's not showing up on the screen right now. But if it's in parentheses, like this one, that means there's no shared segments. If it's not in parentheses, like chromosome two that I've just switched to, then we're going to have little bits colored for where people match. It's going to highlight here who's matching who. And so you can see we've got BL, JY, and JY, Drew D. We have to look at this, and we may need to rotate it around somewhat to be able to see which is which. As you can see right here, there's a couple of white solid lines that almost are on top of each other, and there's these couple of segments. So let's actually rotate this using these little bars at the top here to separate those out. Okay, so we've separated them out a little bit, and we can see that, hey, this first one is JY on top, and it intersects with BL. And along there, there is this segment. Likewise, there's Drew D over here, and it intersects with JY. And so that segment is represented. Now, the nice thing about this visualization of it is, remember, on the table that I showed you before, each matching segment always had two versions of it. For instance, Drew D to JY and JY to Drew D. In this case, the visual representation is smart enough to actually consolidate those into just one. And so you don't see this Drew D down here matching up with this JY, because it already has Drew D over here matching with JY. So that's one of the major advantages of looking at the graphic part of it, is we are only going to have one segment represented for one matching segment, which is what you would want. Now, while this tool does not show you in this view the start and the end location of the segments, what it does is it tells you what centimorgans that segment is. So for instance, this green one on the end here is between 10 and 20 centimorgans, whereas this other blue one here is only between 5 and 10 centimorgans. If I go back to the table, remember, there's four, so that represents two segments because each two is one. And I can see that, yes, I have one that is green, 13 centimorgans, and one that is blue, 8.2 centimorgans. And so if you like using this graphic better than the table, then you're going to be able to use this initially, but you're going to have to go back to the table to see where those segments start and endpoints are. But as you go through them, you'll also, if there are overlaps, you can visually see where some of those overlaps are. Now, in my three people that I chose here, there are not any overlaps. I think this chromosome number 11 was the closest one. Let me just rotate it some, and you can see where all four of those segments, so they don't quite line up. Although this green one here, it might line up right at the edge of it. But that's one of the advantages of this, is you can actually look at the segments and how they fit in multiple different ways as you rotate this around to be able to see where things line up, where a triangulation might be. So the 3D chromosome browser on GEDmatch, again, it is different than your regular 2D chromosome browser that you're going to see from 23andMe, MyHeritage, FamilyTree DNA, or even the other 2D chromosome browsers on GEDmatch. It allows you to look at multiple people against multiple people, as opposed to one person against multiple people. So take a look at this tool, see if you can understand the results that are getting from it, and incorporate it into your genetic genealogy research. If you like learning more about GEDmatch tools, then click on this video at the top. But if you want to learn something else about DNA, then try the video down below.